It's hard.
You can just call DHS on somebody in this city. Now, some people do it just to get back at somebody. But here, it seems like the motivation was to become the parent.
Do you believe your daughter would still be alive if she wasn't placed in DHS care?
Yes, I do.
On February 4th, 2023, an unfortunate incident unfolded in Philadelphia that went largely unnoticed by the public. 2-year-old Sul'Yah Williams lost her life, and her passing was hidden in obscurity. Williams, a vibrant toddler with an infectious smile, was unfortunately found unresponsive and covered in inexplicable bruises. Her case was particularly troubling due to the circumstances leading up to her demise. It began with the involvement of the Pennsylvania Department of Human Services, DHS. At the time, Sul'Yah was living with 23-year-old Denaejah Harper and her partner, 24-year-old Diamond Joyner. Sul'Yah's biological mother, Tytianna Hawthorne, had expressed concerns about the placement of her daughter under DHS care. She questioned why her daughter had been entrusted to Harper and Joyner, as she had strong reservations. The complicated details of this case raised even more questions. Harper was the one who initially prompted a DHS investigation in 2021. The woman reported burn marks on Sul'Yah that she claimed to have seen on Instagram. This led to the commencement of the DHS investigation. Surprisingly, Hawthorne, Sul'Yah's mother, recalled that she had only briefly met Harper during their time living in a group home nearly 7 years prior, and had limited interaction with her since. Following the 2021 investigation, Sul'Yah was placed with Harper, who falsely claimed to be the child's maternal aunt, according to DHS records. Harper was granted custody not once, but twice, despite these discrepancies. Since then, Tytianna has sued a city subcontractor, claiming that the agency's negligence in investigating led to the tragic placement of the child.
This is a 2-year-old girl who was murdered in her home. You can just call DHS on somebody in this city. Now, some people do it just to get back at somebody. But here, it seems like the motivation was to become the parent. Well, how'd that work out? It defies credulity that this person who claims to be a maternal aunt is not, and makes up a story to get DHS involved. DHS would then give the child to her. But that's what happened here.
Months later, medical professionals determined that Sul'Yah's supposed burn marks were in fact a skin condition, leading to a judge granting custody to Sul'Yah's biological father at the end of 2021. What unfolded over the next few months is unclear. Williams lived with her father's family during this period. In May 2022, Harper once again petitioned for custody, and in January 2023, it was granted. Tragically, just 1 week after this custody exchange, Sul'Yah's life was cut short. An autopsy later revealed the gruesome reality behind the 2-year-old's passing. She had succumbed to multiple blunt force impact injuries, including contusions to the intestines and bleeding on the brain. Attorney A.J. Thompson, who represented the 2-year-old's estate, emphasized the gravity of the situation, highlighting that Sul'Yah was essentially ended in that home. The child's biological mother questioned why it took nearly 6 months to acknowledge who was responsible for her daughter's passing when it seemed clear.
How have the last couple of months been for you? How you been handling it?
It's hard.
According to interview notes in DHS files, on the night of her passing, Williams was at home with Diamond Joyner and Joyner's young nephew while Harper was at work. The little boy informed investigators that Joyner had kicked the child twice because she didn't tidy up her toys, causing her to foam at the mouth. Sadly, Sul'Yah passed away a few hours later at the hospital, and the medical examiner subsequently declared it a hummy. The response from the individuals involved in this case only added to the complexity. Despite numerous attempts by news stations to reach Harper and Joyner for their perspective, they have remained unresponsive. Though Joyner, who was arrested and charged with fatality in early August 2023, asserted her innocence through her attorney. In contrast, DHS chose not to comment on the situation at all when contacted by the media. Despite the tragic outcome, the case remained largely hidden from public scrutiny, highlighting the need for more thorough reporting and accountability in such matters. May the family and friends of Sul'Yah Williams find solace in the happy memories, and may her soul rest in perpetual peace. I hope that justice is served. Thank you.